Hello people, in this video, we want to look at this topic, phaco emulsification. Phaco means lens, okay? Phaco means lens. So it's the lens that is there inside our eye. So phaco emulsification. So emulsification of that lens, okay? So this is phaco emulsification. It's a treatment for cataract. What is cataract, guys? Cataract is opacity of the lens, right? So you can see in this diabetic cataract, there is snowflake appearance. So basically this is cataract opacity of the lens. So basically one of the choice of treatment is phaco emulsification. So they will emulsify the lens, right? That is the phaco. They will emulsify the lens and remove it. Okay. So there are treatments for cataract, surgical. Now we are looking at surgical. First of all, here what they're talking about is cataract extraction. So if you're talking about cataract extraction, there are many ways of cataract extraction. There's intracapsular extraction. Okay, intracapsular cataract extraction, extracapsular cataract extraction for adults, then extracapsular cataract extraction for childhood cataract. So basically we are here, you can look at this blue here, right? So phaco emulsification comes under this one. It comes under the extracapsular cataract extraction for adulthood, right? It comes under this. So basically in extracapsular, what exactly is done is, so guys, if this is the eye, this is the lens, right? This is the crystalline lens. So this lens has a anterior part and a posterior part, right? So here also you can see anterior part and posterior part. So basically in extracapsular cataract extraction, what is done, and intracapsular cataract extraction, what is done. See, intracapsular means basically they're removing the capsule, okay? So entire capsule is gone. So now if you look at this one here, so just look at this one here, you have an anterior capsule and a posterior capsule, correct? See, here you have an capsule. Where is capsule? Here you have an anterior capsule mentioned here and a posterior capsule, right? So anterior capsule, posterior capsule, along with the entire nucleus cortex, everything removed, is an intracapsular cataract extraction. So the entire cataractous lens along with the intact capsule is removed. Okay. So this is actually not preferred. They don't like this so much. Now coming to extracapsular cataract extraction, here everything they're removing except, you know, that posterior capsule. Except this posterior capsule, they will remove everything. So posterior capsule will be intact. Okay, so this is a more preferred one, extracapsular cataract extraction is more preferred, you know, because they are leaving the posterior capsule intact. Okay, so basically here the side effects, or whatever you can say, the post-operative effects will be less, right? The complications will be less, etc. So basically in this, there are three techniques, okay? So there is conventional extracapsular cataract extraction, ECCE, extracapsular cataract extraction. So usually they refer to this one, conventional. Conventional is a simple technique, doctor, whoever is trained in it, easy for them to learn. But there will be long incision, and this is an open chamber surgery, okay? So you can see here a kind of photo that we got from the internet. So extracapsular cataract extraction, they are removing the lens. You can see the lens is coming out here. So they are removing the lens, guys. And this is like, there's a big incision, is big, right? So this is the extracapsular cataract extraction. We won't go into details of this conventional one. So then came this manual small incision cataract surgery. Okay. So this one. Hold on. So this one, manual small incision cataract surgery, that is SICS. Okay. So basically this is small incision cataract surgery. You can see this small incision cataract surgery is actually sutureless cataract. The entry is via a scleral tunnel. Okay. So this is also a low cost alternative to phaco emulsification, which we'll be looking at now. So here via the sclera, you can see here, they have made a tunnel and they are entering and they will try to remove the lens. So basically this is the minimal, this is the small incision cataract surgery. Okay. Now what is better, even better, is this phaco emulsification. So that is the topic of this video, isn't it? So you have understood the basics as to where we are coming from. Now we are coming to phaco emulsification, adulthood cataract, one of the options in extracapsular cataract extraction. So once you remove the lens, what will you do? You will follow it up with a artificial lens, that is intraocular lens implantation. Okay, that is IOL. So basically, phaco is lens. So here this is pseudophakia, okay, where there is artificial lens. Aphakia will be there after the surgery. After the surgery, aphakia, because you remove the lens, right? So after this aphakia, you will put this artificial lens and it will become pseudophakia. So now guys, this phaco emulsion, we have come to the topic exact here. So this is nothing but extracapsular cataract extraction by what? By phaco emulsification, right? And they will follow it up with a intraocular lens implantation. What type of intraocular lens implantation, guys? Foldable posterior chamber intraocular lens implantation is the choice of surgery they are saying. Okay, so what lens are you putting, guys? A foldable posterior chamber intraocular lens. Okay, so basically the thing here is, in phaco emulsification, what they are doing is this is very important. The lens nucleus is emulsified. Okay, they will kind of just break it up. Okay, and then whatever pieces are there, they will aspirate it with a probe. So they'll suck out those parts. Okay, so this is something that you should understand. Basic thing you should understand, that they are emulsifying the lens and they're just removing all those pieces with a probe. Suction kind of a thing. Okay, so basic idea you have got, right? So basically this is a very good surgery in the sense that there will be less complication. Okay, guys, you have understood, right? So if this is the eye and here the lens is there, so let us say this is the eye and here the lens is there, they will kind of go here, break this up nucleus into small pieces, emulsify, and then they will suck it out. Okay, then they will give you a new lens. So this is phaco emulsification, completely our understanding. You will have to read better books to understand this better. Okay, the advantages are that there is a very small incision, right? If you go through a scleral tunnel, then a sutureless surgery is possible. So visual rehabilitation, early visual rehabilitation of the patient happens, and there is very less astigmatism. The complication, post-operative astigmatism and all, is less. Okay, so basically what are the merits of phaco emulsion over other techniques? Topical anesthesia may be sufficient. Wow, topical anesthesia is sufficient. Post-operative congestion is minimal. Okay, small incision, we already told you, less corneal complications. Then visual rehabilitation is comparatively quicker. Post-operative astigmatism is also less. All these advantages you already know. Now, what are the disadvantages? Let us look at the demerits also. So demerits are that the learning curve for the doctor is more. He has to learn this very complicated procedure. So there can be something like a nuclear drop, which is a very, very bad thing if it happens during the surgery. So where exactly this nucleus will be dropped? Into the vitreous cavity. So this is really, really bad. Okay, so let's just try to understand this again. So what you saw in extracapsular cataract extraction, you saw that there will be an intact posterior capsule. Posterior capsule will be kept intact, right? So if you go here into the diagram, you'll be able to understand better. Look at this one. So basically, the posterior capsule, they have kept it intact, right? And they are removing the cataractous lens, right? So now, this the nucleus, they are emulsifying, the lens they are emulsifying. And if there is a nuclear drop into the vitreous is here, that is a very, very bad thing. So I'm thinking maybe this posterior capsule will rupture, and because of which it will drop into the vitreous. What do you say? Okay. So that is one understanding. Let's continue with the demerits of phaco emulsification. So then what happens? This is machine dependent. So it is so dependent on the machine that if machine fails, then there can be problem. Then it is also costly. right? Obviously, the doctor has to learn so much about it. It's machine dependent, so you need a machine, so it is costly. Limitations are that you can't deal with hard cataracts, right? Obviously, you're trying to break the lens and you're trying to emulsify it. So with hard cataracts, it's difficult to deal with it. So understand that before the phaco emulsification itself, they have to assess the grade of the hardness of this cataract, isn't it? So they should know what the grade of hard cataract is. Here, grade 4, grade 5, they have written. It is very difficult to deal with hard cataracts. Okay. So it makes sense, right? So what is the conclusion here? In spite of these demerits, phaco emulsification has become a preferred method of cataract extraction because the complication rate in the hands of an expert doctor is very less. And visual rehabilitation is fast, and why not, right? It's about money is more, I think, when it comes to health and money. If I would rather give a little more money and have a very comfortable surgery and fast recovery, then yeah. Okay, so now let us come to the procedure, guys. Exactly what is done, let us look at this. Guys, note that there are a lot of YouTube videos which explain these surgeries really well, okay? Here we will be looking only at theory, right? So some nice videos on YouTube you should look at for the procedure in practical, okay? So let us look at this clear corneal incision. So they'll make a very small incision, 3 millimeter. If they do a sclera corneal tunnel, then they can do a sutureless surgery, okay? So it will be a self-sealing sclera corneal tunnel, or they can make a clear corneal incision, 3 millimeter, that we already told you. Now let us move to the next step. The next step will be continuous curvilinear capsular hexis. So let's break this word, curvilinear capsular hexis. Okay. So basically CCC, continuous curvilinear capsular hexis. So basically 4 to 6 millimeter. So what do they do here? Anterior capsulotomy. So they are removing the anterior capsule. Now, hydrodissection. Separation of capsule from the cortex by injecting fluid exactly between the two. My God, that sounds nice but complicated. Yeah, that is where the training of the doctor is very important in this. And then, so they will inject where? Between the cortex and the capsule, right? So let us see A here. Clear corneal incision, continuous curvilinear capsular hexis. They are breaking the anterior capsule. Then hydrodissection. So exactly between the capsule and the cortex, they are injecting some fluid. Then D, hydrodelineation. Okay. What is this hydrodelineation? It says some surgeons prefer this hydrodelineation. So basically what they have done here is they have injected some fluid between the capsule and the cortex. So now the nucleus can rotate. You understand, right? So the nucleus can rotate. So they have put a fluid here. The nucleus can rotate. So now what they are going to do? Nucleus is emulsified. So nucleus emulsification E and F by divide and conquer technique. 4-quadrant cracking. So E and F. So what they are doing, they are kind of breaking, right? Emulsifying the nucleus. How's it going, people? We are breaking. This is the word that we are using. Actually, textbook says emulsification. So what are they using here to emulsify? They have a phaco emulsifier. Okay. It is, it acts through a hollow 1 millimeter titanium needle. Okay. That's a titanium needle, 1 millimeter hollow titanium needle. It vibrates by a piezoelectric crystal in its longitudinal axis. So it has a speed, ultrasonic speed, 40,000 times per second. Wow. 40,000 times per second. It will, what will it do? It will vibrate and thus it will emulsify the nucleus. Nucleus emulsified. Okay. Then, there are many ways of doing this. Chip and flip technique, divide and conquer technique, stop and chop technique, direct phaco chop technique. Wow. So there are 4 techniques, guys. Actually, in YouTube, you'll get a lot of videos. The one that shows here is written something here. Didn't they say some? Okay, they didn't say. There are a lot of videos which say the method. Okay. So what and all methods are there? Chip and flip, divide and conquer, stop and chop, direct phaco chop technique. Okay. Then what will they do after all this? Now they have to aspirate, correct? So remaining cortical lens matter is aspirated. So they have a irrigation aspiration technique. Then lastly, they will implant a IOL. So here they are talking about implantation of foldable IOL with injector system. Fine. So a foldable IOL implantation with the help of an injector is the most ideal. It's most ideal with phaco emulsification technique. However, phaco profile rigid IOL can also be implanted after enlarging the incision. So if it is foldable, it will just go in. But if it is a phaco profile rigid IOL, then you will have to enlarge the incision. Looks like that. Okay. Then after all this, what they will do? They will remove viscoelastic substance and wound closure. Okay. That is very similar to the small incision cataract surgery. So guys, you understood, right? So if this is the eye, if this is the cornea, so they will make a small incision, go in, they will, that anterior capsule, they will do hexes, right? Then they will inject some fluid so that it can rotate freely. Then they will do they will do emulsification of the nucleus, all the nucleus papa, all nucleus will be chop. Then what they will do, they will aspirate this content out, right? After aspirating the content out through an injector, they will put an intraocular lens, that is a pseudophakia, artificial lens that we put. Okay. So this is totally our understanding of this phaco emulsification technique, guys. Now let us look at some other things here. They are concluding with so many newer things like micro incision cataract surgery. Okay, under that micro incision coaxial phaco emulsification, bimanual micro phaco emulsification, phaconet, femtosecond laser assisted cataract surgery is the best available procedure currently. Oops. Okay. So about this femtosecond laser assisted cataract surgery also you can read, guys. So basically our idea was to cover this phaco emulsification concept. Hope you have understood. So it is a treatment for cataract. You saw that it is an extracapsular cataract extraction for adulthood cataracts, right? Then basically the definition of it, nucleus is emulsified, aspirated. Then they will put a foldable, right, posterior chamber intraocular lens. That's what they said. So this is a better surgery because very small incision, early visual rehabilitation. It's costly, but there is very little chance of astigmatism, right? So only topical anesthesia is required. Interesting, right? Some bad things could be the nucleus drop into the vitreous cavity. If the surgeon is very, very trained, then absolutely no issues. That's what they're saying. Procedure you looked at, curvy, linear, capsular, hexes, hydrodissection. All these words are important, guys. Then this diagram, if you want, you can draw it. That's all. So we have looked at phaco emulsification. Bye-bye.